Chamber pressure is nominal.
T-plus 33 seconds into the test flight of the inaugural Starship vehicle. Tower cleared, wind of pitch over. Propulsion reports first stage engines nominal. What a sight from the ground cameras at Stardust. We're flying at twice the thrust of the Saturn V heading to space.
Acquisition of signal, Corpus Christi.
We're throttled down and throttled back up. Going through the period of maximum aerodynamic pressure. As the velocity increases, the density of the atmosphere is decreasing.
Max Q.
Lessening stress on the vehicle. The call out, Max Q now.
Clear the pad and make it this far into the test flight, the first integrated.
Our next major activity is going to be set down of the first stage. Houston Tracking Station now acquiring the vehicle. With set down, we will get separation of Starship from Super Heavy and ignition of the Starship engines. When Starship separates, we light up six engines in a staggered sequence. If all goes well, those six engines will burn for almost 6.5 minutes. Onboard view from Starship. And there's views of the Raptor engines on the second stage as we prepare for stage separation. Now, after stage separation, the first stage will flip and begin a boost back maneuver for landing in the Gulf. Continuing to fly, 2 minutes, 40 seconds. Let's get ready for main engine cutoff.
Booster engine cutoff.
Beginning the flip for stage separation.
As of right now, we are awaiting stage separation, where Starship should separate from the Super Heavy booster.
Yeah, Kate, right now it looks like we saw the start of the flip, but obviously we're seeing from the ground cameras the entire Starship stack continuing to rotate. We should have had separation by now. Obviously, this does not appear to be a nominal situation.
Yeah, it does appear to be spinning, but I do want to remind everyone that everything after clearing the tower was icing on the cake. And there, as you saw, as we promised, an exciting end to the Starship inaugural integrated test flight.